In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Blessed be with you. It's very good to welcome you here tonight as we come together to celebrate this massive chrism, which in the context of the Eucharist, our priests will renew their promises to serve, and which will bless the words, the sign and symbol of that sacramental ministry. It's great to be here tonight, particularly as we celebrate the dying as the last moments of our living life. It's almost a bust for us. Just days to go, Father, thank you so much. And both for having us tonight, but also for your ministry in this place. It's still over so many years. And you're so much love for us as we move into retirement. Thank you for all you've done to serve over the years. It's a chance to thank everybody after such a bizarre and strange year. And yet one in which Christian and our ministry has continued and in many ways flourished. And you have so many things. And so important in these our circumstances, we gather to dedicate ourselves anew to that service. It's good to have a true voice on the right. And also we go on behalf of Deacon Mark, representing both of our leaders, and also by way of Nick McKee, our director of vocations, who does so much to foster and encourage our vocations within our community. We need, above all, to celebrate the Mass. And as we gather, we listen to the words of Christ. We feed on his life in the bread and wine of the Eucharist. And so to prepare ourselves, let us reflect on our lives and call to mind our sins. We are sent to heal the contract of heart. Lord, have mercy. Sins. Christ have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest and peace to his people. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and with power to bring to the world the blessings of your kingdom. Anoint your church with the same Holy Spirit, that we you share in his suffering and victory, may bear witness to the gospel of salvation. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Instead of war.
For I am the Lord who love justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. This is the word of the Lord. In response to the psalm, I will sing forever of your love, O Lord.
I will sing forever of your love, O Lord.
I have found David my servant, and with my holy love anointed him. My hand shall always be with him, and my arm shall make him strong.
I will sing forever of your love, O Lord.
My truth and my love shall be with him. By my name, his might shall be exalted. He will say to me, "You are my Father, my God, the rock who saved
me." I will sing forever of your love, O Lord.
Because he has a duty to bring good news to the strange chrism this is. No procession, no kind of celebration, people face masked and socially distanced, no refreshments afterwards, a fraction of annual attendance, and yet it's so important, this year, above all things, we gather for this mass. I want to say a huge thank you to the many people here tonight, small in number, all of this mass is packed with many people. Thank you, those of you here in church, those of you watching online, for being here tonight, to accept, to represent all those who we as a college of priests seek to serve. All that we do is in the service of you and of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So thank you for your presence this evening. And I apologize if some of what I say is more directed to the priests, but it's because we matter so much and some things I need to say to them. A simplified chrism and a simple sermon, because I just have in two words to speak to you tonight, thinking about the two actions of our Mass. This evening, first of all, our priests will renew the promises of ordination, and as they do that, I have a word of thanks. And the second, we will bless and consecrate these words, we will be used as signs and symbols of our ministry. And as we do that, I have a word of encouragement. So first, as we think about the ordination, a word of thanks. It's hard to think of a tougher year for Christian ministry going back centuries than the one that we've just endured. It has been incredibly difficult. On a personal level, for many years, it's been lonely and hard to get through, and ministry has been tough. And of course, we've been coped with extreme hardship in our congregation. See our people through the stresses and anxieties of an extended national crisis. Some of you have had to minister to the sick, of not able to visit. Some of many of you have sought to see people through times of grief. Even in days when you have had to minister to people in funeral ministry the way they would like to. You've seen levels of poverty and destitution that even for many of you who experienced priests have found quite shocking. And on two occasions we've had to endure that that's the worst thing of all, depriving our people of the sacraments of life as we've had to close the public worship. That has been such a hard year. How have we endured? Well, the gospel we listen to tonight, I think, tells us. Jesus reads Isaiah chapter 61 in the synagogue of Nazareth. And we read that every eye in the temple was fixed on him. The people were fascinated by him. That's how we got through this past year. We've kept our eyes fixed on Jesus. So thank you for that. And thank you, Bible, for keeping your eyes fixed on Jesus in the Mass. The ministry that many of you have shown in the past year has been remarkable. Incredibly imaginative, incredibly agile. You've learned to live stream, master the online environment. You found new ways to reach out and serve the need of more speed than the rough statutory authorities astonished. You've adjusted to constantly changing or often contradictory and nonsensical regulations. But the most remarkable thing now is to maintain the Catholic disciplines and above all, to go on celebrating the Mass. The silence is our year. We suggested that the Mass is a kind of optional extra we can switch off when it's inconvenient. But no. There are others who suggested that watching it on TV is as good as the real thing. And that's all our worship has kept our congregations together. It is not adequate. What our nation is needed, more than we can understand or acknowledge, is faithful priests at the altar. Proclaiming the death of Jesus Christ, because that death sets us free from death, and proclaiming the resurrection, because in Jesus there is hope. So as you come to renew the promises of your ordination, us a clear route out of this book. But that asks a big question. What next for the church and for us as Christians? The challenges we now face in the Christian life in this country are formidable. Many of you must be. Many of you report to me that children and family ministry has been particularly badly hit. Some of you have had to put cherished plans on hold. Many of you in parishes in the world about money and finances and shame. It was hard to work down. It could be hard still to unlock. So how do we do it? And the answer is the same. We keep our eyes fixed upon Jesus Christ. It's tempting in response to a crisis to want to look backwards, to use all sorts of words beginning with wisdom, recovery. It's tempting to want to retreat, to try first, gently and quietly get back to where we were, before we can start to look to the future. When I look at the words of the saints and the scriptures, what I see again and again is people responding to crisis, not by looking back, but by looking forward, by looking to what God is doing next, responding to crisis through a fresh commitment to the mission. Think about Paul in silence, burrowed in the prison cell, but even in the cell while worshiping and praising God. And when the prison falls down, they don't rush off, they stay, they share the faith with the jailer. That crisis, that lockdown, is simply a springboard to a fresh evangelism. And that surely is how it has been for us as we keep our eyes fixed upon Jesus Christ. Our response to this crisis must be a fresh commitment to the mission of the church. And as we take these words, they assure us the way. So first of all, we embrace the oil of baptism. And that reminds us of our call to be evangelists. As we use this oil in the baptism of people into the church, so we're reminded of our call to help people along the road to faith in Jesus Christ. Without hope, life is thin, hopeless, short, purposeless. The words we speak are words of life. The sacraments we celebrate are sacraments of life. What we do is literally a matter of life and death as we draw people from death to eternity. I'm so fed up with people saying Catholics don't do mission or can't do mission. We can. We do. We are. And so as we come out of this crisis, let's commit ourselves to a confident and bold Catholic mission in which we seek to invite men and women and children to fresh life as they encounter Jesus in the Eucharist. Let's ensure that all our churches are places where people can find a home, their true home in Jesus Christ. And that work in evangelism begins in prayer. When we pray for Sunday, we pray for the conversion of people. Let's pray that prayer every day, and as we take this oil backwards, let's commit ourselves anew to our work as evangelists. And the second night, we embrace the oil of the sick, and all that it reminds us of our calling to be healers. This pandemic has damaged so many lives, so many of them are anxious or afraid. So we will see the breakdown of relationships or a lie to be meant to suffer. Our call is to be healers within our congregations, but also beyond our congregations. Never allow yourselves to be turned into mere chaplains for gathered congregations. Your responsibility is the cure of souls, the healing of souls, the every soul in the parishes where you work. So be bold in that ministry. Use this oil generously. These words then show us to keep our eyes fixed upon Jesus as well as they did in the synagogue. They challenge us not to look backwards to what to simply the church. They challenge us to a fresh and bold vision of our ministry, to minister as priests and as lay people with courage and with confidence. Bishop Julian always tells me the word proud. He says it's a sin. We're going to sin boldly. Because I am incredibly proud of you and of what you've done in this past year. Or to be precise, proud of what God has done in your lives and through your lives. Thank you so much for your faithfulness and your courage over this past year. And now, we need the promises of your ordination boldly and take these words with you. Go back to unlock your churches and to unlock the gospel, that the people of this nation might see that they have a Savior in Jesus Christ, our Lord and God. Amen. to yourselves, grow closer to Christ. It didn't come all about him. Show your pleasures and ambitions to bring his peace and love to your brothers and sisters.
I hope the world, I hope.
With the example of the world, who washed his disciples' feet, we faithful serving the needs of others, and diligent in caring for those in need and trouble, in strengthening the faithful, and in searching out the indifferent and the lost. Ask the Lord to bless us with the fullness of his power, that we may be faithful servants of Christ, our great prince, serving the church with gifts that encourage and equip the people of God and make Christ known in our generation.
Lord Jesus Christ, hear us and answer our prayer.
Almighty God, who's given us the will to undertake these things, give us also strength to perform, that he may complete that work which he has begun in us, through Jesus Christ. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing.
The order of the mighty was sick and dying. Blessed be you, sovereign God, gentle and merciful, creator of heaven and earth. Your word brought light out of darkness, and daily your spirit renews the face of the earth. Your anointed Son brought healing to those in weakness and distress. He broke the power of evil and set us free from sin and death, that we might praise your name forever. By the power of your Spirit, may your blessing rest of those who are anointed with this oil in your name. May they be made whole in body, mind, and spirit, restored in your image, renewed in your love, and serve you as sons and daughters in your kingdom.
Yes, we will forever.
Blessed are you, sovereign God, the protector of all who believe in you. Your anointed Son overcame the powers of evil when he was lifted high upon the cross. By the power of your Spirit, may your blessing rest on those who are united with this world in your name as they come to the waters of baptism. May be for them a sign of your defense in their fight against sin, the world and the devil, and bring them to share in Christ's victory. Bless the Lord Chrism and the priest who stretch out a hand as we consecrate this well. The oil of Chrism. Blessed are you, sovereign God and eternal Father, upholding by your grace all who hear your call. Under your old covenant, priests and kings were anointed to serve you, and in the fullness of time, you anointed your Son by the Holy Spirit to be the Christ, the Saviour and Servant of all. By the power of your Spirit, may your blessing rest on those who are anointed with this chrism in your name. Let it be for them a sign of joy and gladness, as they share in the royal priesthood of the new covenant, and make known the kingdom of Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you of the Holy Spirit, we lift our voices of thanks and praise.
Blessed be the Lord, our strength and our salvation, now and forever.
God has made us born in Christ. He has set his seal upon us, and as the pledge of what is to come, has given the Holy Spirit to dwell in our hearts. The peace of the Lord.
Thank you.
let us never act to all your love. It is indeed right and good, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord. Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. By the outpouring of your Holy Spirit, you anointed him to be the servant of all, and ordained that he should enter into your kingdom through suffering. Now he stands by us, and pours out for our food, the word of consolation, and the wine of mead. In your wisdom and love, you anoint your Holy People to be a royal priesthood, to share in Christ's suffering, and reveal its glory to the world. Therefore, every night we come to sing a new song in your presence. We too join the angels and archangels as they proclaim your glory without end. Holy, 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 God of God, saying, drink this, all. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for the good for men, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Is the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will be again. And so now, all those who have it is done for the cross. His perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world. Rejoice in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. And looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our village. As we offer you this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence as sick. Send the Holy Spirit on your kingdom, and gather into one of your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, St. Anne, and all the saints, may praise the God of God the Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, and glory in the universe, She's been able to connect with more prayer